orphan sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Rise up, rise up,
oh,
rise up,
out from the grave like Lazarus. When he said your name, the thing that filled your veins was more than blood, it's a kind of love that washes sin away. Now the door is open wide, and the stone's been rolled aside. The old is gone, the light has come, so come on and rise up. Take a breath, you're alive now. Can't...
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Aren't you glad to be in the house of the Lord today? All right, let's look to the back of our bulletin. We have some announcements and we have some celebrations. So we just had breakfast blessings right now. We are in worship. Thank you all for being here.
Tuesday night, there will be a ladies' auxiliary meeting. I've been informed you guys are going out to eat, but you're meeting here at the Fellowship Hall at 6 o'clock. Thursday night, we're having our kids and youth meeting at 6 o'clock in the Fellowship Hall as well. Next Sunday is Youth Sunday, so please come and support the young people of our church. They would greatly appreciate it. And June 19th through 24th is Cragmont Youth Conference. We already have our kids who are going for that, and thanks to you guys, no kid is having to pay out of pocket to go to summer camp.
Amen.
So praise the Lord for your service and your dedication to these young people of this church. Thank you very much. On July 2nd, that is the Sunday before the 4th, we are having family picnic out here in the back. We have a great gospel bluegrass group called River Crossing coming to do music with us. We're going to have some barbecue, and it's going to be fun. We're just going to hang out and praise the Lord and have some food. We all like to do that, right? All right, cool. July 16th through 20th is Vacation Bible School. We're going to make this whole place look like a castle. We're going to learn about the armor of God, and we're going to have some sword fights, and we're going to ride some horses, and we're going to do some jousting. And no, some of that may or may not be true, but it's going to be a very, very fun week. It's going to be a great week, and we need your help. So if you want to help that week, stay in touch with me, or Tammy is raising her hand. Yes, ma'am. You bring a horse? Yes. We got a horse. Look at that. I didn't even have to ask. That's amazing. No, I'll let you know. We'll be meeting very soon. I will let everybody know when we're meeting. If you are interested in helping, we want you guys to help. And you don't have to come every night to help. I know that people have work. People have other things going on. It's the summer. Some people are traveling. Don't say, well, I can't be there two of the nights, so I'm not going to help at all. We want you to serve, and we have capacities in which you can serve just a little bit or a whole lot. So if you're interested in serving in any capacity, please let me know or let Miss Christy Shingleton know, and we would be happy to get you plugged in. And stay tuned for an official announcement as far as our next meeting goes. So there are a couple things that are happening today here at the church. So a little later in the service, we are going to be honoring our graduates. But immediately following the service, we will be having a wedding ceremony right here in the church for Jesse and Destiny. So if you have a few minutes to stay after, that's going to start right at noon. It's not going to be very long, maybe 15 or 20 minutes. If you guys want to stay and show your support to them, I'm sure they would appreciate it. And also, it's a busy day. We have a baby shower this afternoon in the Fellowship Hall for Brittany and Ashton as they are welcoming their new baby into the world. So let's show up and support them. It's important that we support each other. What'd you say? 2 to 4? What did I say? I didn't say. Okay, 2 to 4, and it's floating, and I used to think that meant that like we had to like come in on roller skates and like float around. You don't actually have to float. That just means you can come when you want and leave when you want, which is really cool. No actual floating is required, so no worries if you don't have that athletic ability. I got one person to laugh. That's great. Okay, so it's very important that we support the members of our community and the members of our church. Whatever it is they're going through, joys, celebrations, times of sorrow, we are here for one another. So thank you guys for showing up and showing out for your church family. Everyone really, really appreciates it. So we have a few birthdays and an anniversary this week that we're also celebrating. We'll look at that as well. Bobby Manning is June 6th. Joshua Strickland is June 10th. And Jared and Elizabeth Gray have their anniversary on June 10th. Are there any other announcements, birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, babies, anything I may have missed? All right. In that case, Chris, would you please lead us in prayer?
Lord, thank you so much for each and all the blessings that you've given us last week. Lord, thank you so much. Through the graduating work, we want to say thank you for them. I'm reminded of our services that are working for our freedom overseas, Lord. I ask a special blessing on them. And for those that are sick and shut in, there are unable people this day. Lord, we ask you a special blessing on them too. Lord, as we go into this service, we ask you to open our hearts and our minds that we may receive the word that you have for us today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Our scripture reading for today will be out of Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth, who have displayed your splendor above the heavens. From the mouths of infants and nursing babes, you have established strength because of your adversaries to make the enemy and the revengeful cease. When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you take thought of him, and the son of man that you care for him? Yet you have made him a little lower than God. You crown him with glory and majesty. You make him to rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the heavens and the fish of the sea, whatever passes through the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Amen.
Let's all stand together and sing number 11, All Creatures of Our God and King.
And good morning. You know what thrills me the most today? We got a house full and I'm actually preaching. A lot of times when we have your biggest crowd, something's going on and the preacher is not preaching that day. I don't know what time we're going to get done today. I'm just kidding. Y'all know me better than that. But the bottom line is, it is with a joyful heart that I bring you greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So glad to see each of you. So glad to see the smiles on your faces. So glad that you could be here to help us celebrate and honor our graduates. And we'll be beginning that part of our worship in just a bit. So we do have guests with us in worship today. Home folks, absolutely nobody. Nobody gets to leave this house of worship without a smile and a handshake and a welcome. So please accept my welcome today, but that's what we all do. We are the church, and we are in community together, and part of what churches do, we love on each other a little bit. So thank you for doing that, and let's just praise the Lord for his presence with us as we gather to worship him today. We would like to call attention today to some very special folks. And I have just put pages out of order. I'm going to fix that right now. I am having a bad moment. I am seriously having a bad moment. Let's see. There's page 3. Uh-oh. And there's page 1. I am apologizing, but the only one way to fix this is to look for it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okie dokie. All right. There's just no smooth way to do that, folks, I'll tell you. But we are here to celebrate those who have reached milestones in their lives, from our youngest children who have finished up one part of their early childhood as they prepare for their tomorrows, to those who are even earning advanced degrees. We want to celebrate those accomplishments today. And so what I'm going to ask, and as I call your name, and for some of our kindergartners, a mom or a dad or a sibling, if you'd like to kind of walk up here, it can kind of be a little bit scary walking up here by themselves. Whatever your child needs to be, feel comfortable. That is totally okay, but we want to recognize their accomplishments today. So first, we're going to recognize Bella Rose Boquin. Bella has graduated from kindergarten at LaVie Academy on May 15th. She is part of the Washington Elite Cheer Team and loves to drive her go-kart in her free time, and I love to ride go-karts too. She will be in the first grade this fall. Congratulations, Bella. Sarah Cook graduated from Pitt Community College on May 9th with an associate's degree in applied science and biotechnology. She served for 3 years as a student ambassador and was the recipient of the Pitt Community College Student Ambassador Program Scholarship and was a Maine Farmer Scholar. She finished her program with a 3.75 GPA. Congratulations on that good work. She plans to continue working locally in the pharmaceutical industry and furthering her education. Ashlyn McNish recently graduated from East Carolina University with a master's in clinical health psychology. She received a full scholarship from the psychology department. She was the recipient of the 2022-23 Graduate Student Award for Applied Clinical Services. Her thesis is entitled, and I'm going to try real hard to pronounce this correctly, The Impact of Illness Perception in Cardiopulmonary Rehabilitation Patients, an exploratory study in rural eastern North Carolina. She plans to pursue her education in the field with an anticipated PhD with graduation in 2025. Madison Mills. Madison graduated from Greenville Christian Academy, where she attended from kindergarten right through grade 12. She is her class valedictorian, congratulations, with a GPA of 4.25. During her time at Greenville Christian, she played volleyball for 6 years, and with the last two teams serving as the team libero. Libero. I even looked that up to make sure I pronounced it correctly, but I hear it 40 different ways all over the place. She was a member of the Youth Hunter Education Safety Tournament for six years, competing in trap, rifle, marksmanship, and archery. She also served as vice president of the shooting team for the past 2 years. She has taken piano for 9 years and served on the faculty as a piano teacher for 2 years and has blessed us with her piano playing here at Gum Swamp. She also served on the Student Government Association for 1 year and served in the National Honor Society for 3 years and was on the yearbook staff for 3 years. She was a recipient of the All-State Academic Athletic Teams Award for having the highest GPA of any female senior athlete. She also won the North Carolina Christian School Association State Fine Arts Festival Second Place Award for participating in senior high music for classical piano solo. She plans to attend East Carolina University this fall, where she intends to major in business administration and finance, and she plans to continue teaching piano lessons and furthering her piano studies while at ECU. She would also like to thank her parents, Angie and Chris Mills, grandparents, Carol and Aubrey and Brown, and Cheryl and Philip Mills, her boyfriend, Xander, and all of her family and church families for their love, support, and encouragement. And she is thankful to God for his blessings and for having had the opportunity to attend a Christian school where she has grown academically as well as spiritually. And she adds, I love you all very much. Ava Moore. Ava graduated from HB Sub Elementary School in June 6th. She received the most outstanding in math. I love it when little girls love math. For her third 9-week period, and she enjoys ballet and tap dancing as well as t-ball. And she will begin first grade in the fall. And when she grows up, I love this. She wants to be a nurse or a doctor. I love that. Congratulations, Ava. Matthew Peden. There he is. Matthew will graduate on August 8th from Pitt Community with an associate's degree in welding. He has been an active member of the Formal Community Theater and wishes to continue doing theater, and he plans on attending classes at the North Carolina Theater Conservatory. So Matthew, congratulations in both your welding pursuits and in your theatrical pursuits. Jacob Spain. Jacob Spain graduated from North Carolina State University on May 4th with a bachelor's degree in engineering. He graduated cum laude. That means with honors, with a 3.5 GPA. He will be working as a mechanical engineer for NAVTAR Marine Corps Air Station in Cherry Point. Let's congratulate these young men and women. Make sure we get the little ones on the side so they can be seen. Don't put them behind the podium. There you go. That's right. Stay right there for a moment if you don't mind, because we want to have a prayer for you. I'm going to lead us in a prayer, and then in a few moments we're going to conclude this by sharing Aaron's blessing. The words are printed in your bulletin, but they'll also be on your screen. And I think it would be appropriate for all of us to stand for this prayer. Let us pray.
Father in heaven,
we give you thanks for these young men and women, these boys and girls who have done well and have moved from one part of their lives to another. And Father, we pray your continued blessing on them as they seek to grow as Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and favor with God and with others. Father, may your Holy Spirit rest upon them as they continue their studies or as they move into the world of work. Wherever they are in their station of life, help them to know that you are with us always. And Father, hear us all as we bless them together in the way you taught Aaron to pray, saying, The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his face upon you and give you peace. Amen. God bless you all. Thank you. Congratulations. Well done. Congratulations. You may be seated. I'd like to thank Cadison for helping to pull together all of those wonderful words about these young people. And a lot of times, if I lose what I have up here, I can go on, but I needed every one of those words written today. So thank you for your help. As we share our joys and concerns with each other, I know in addition to what we have printed in the bulletin, we have items that call for our attention today. Let's remember J.W. J.W. is not doing well, and possibly some fluid that's beginning to accumulate. They're waiting to hear from the doctor, but he's not doing well, and he needs our prayer. So please, please remember him. Let's continue to remember Steve. He's doing better, but he's not where he needs to be or wants to be. And we want to pray God's Spirit to be with him and with Miss Faye. We miss them. They're such a always in the same place every Sunday, so we miss them when they're not here. I would ask your blessings upon a group of us this week. Cadison's going to Cragmont a little bit later on, but I'm going this Monday through Wednesday for the ministers' conference. So I get to hang out with a bunch of preachers this week. Pray for me. No, seriously, we do pray for that conference, and actually I'm speaking tomorrow night, so if you would hold me in prayer that I'll have something to say worth hearing for my fellow ministers. So, but we'll be traveling. We'll be back probably on Wednesday evening if all goes well. And, of course, remember that we have our wedding celebration. It'll be a little bit of gab. We'll dismiss because we're going to need to do a little bit of setup up here, but as close to noon as possible, we'll be having the wedding following this service. And also the shower, there y'all are. Got the shower this afternoon from 2 to 4, so it's a busy day at Gumswamp Church. Any other requests for prayer? Yes. Pauline Cole. Yes.
Murray Caraway's up here already, but Mike Caraway and Sarah Best and Jacqueline Kelly.
Mike Caraway, Jacqueline Kelly, and I missed the one in the middle.
Sarah Best.
Sarah Best. Any others? Any joys that you would share with your church family this morning? Well, the day has already been a joyful day, and we celebrate these folks and their accomplishments. I'd like just to give a shout out to Cadison. He just went out gallivanting last week when he wasn't here. Last weekend, he was back with a group that he toured with when he was in school at Lee University. Voices of Lee, as they were singing at the Gaither Family Fest up in Gatlinburg. So I don't know what it feels like to hang out with Gloria and Bill. I'm sure it was quite a sacrifice not being with the folks at Gum Swamp, but we're glad that you're but we're glad that you're here today too, brother. Any other joys? God is good, and all the time, and in that faith we pray. O Lord our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Yours is the name that is above every name. We know that one day every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. But what a joy it is for us to do that now. To acknowledge you for who you are. To acknowledge you as our Creator. To acknowledge you as our Lord. To acknowledge you as our Savior. Oh Lord, you are so worthy of our praise. And yet as we praise you and draw near to you, we are reminded that there's so much in our lives that really isn't that glorious. And we have to acknowledge that we are sinners, that we go our way instead of your way, that we fail to love our neighbors as ourselves, and we fail to love you with all our hearts. So Lord, hear us as we confess our sins. But even in confession, we do this with joy because we know you are more willing to forgive than we are even to ask. Father, we pray your blessing upon these, your people who have gathered in your house to worship you today. We come from many different places. We come facing many challenges. Some each day presents challenge. Each day brings adversity. Well, we thank you that for a few moments that we can lay that aside and focus on you. But Father, we'd be remiss if we didn't lift up one another in prayer to support each other with words of encouragement, to support each other by being friends, by being neighbors. So Lord, as we ask you to pour your blessings on us, we ask that you would also allow us to open ourselves to your Spirit, that we might be the means of your blessing. So Father, when we pray for you to bless others, we also pray that you would enable us to be a blessing, to live a life of joy, the joy of service. Hear all our prayers, O Lord, as we offer for those who are sick and are hurting, those who are facing grief, those who are bereaved, those who need that special touch. So we trust you, O Lord, to suit a blessing to meet the needs of each of our children. And we pray that you would hear us all as we pray the way you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Every good and perfect gift comes from God. Every breath we take, every beat of our heart is a gift from God. As an expression of our stewardship, we return a portion of that blessing to God to be used for the work of his kingdom's work. To express our thanksgiving, let's stand together and sing the doxology.
Praise God.
A little bit taller than I am.
worship.
Okay, let's stand.
So,
now is the time to worship, so let's stand together and sing, "Come, now is the time to worship," number 30.
Come, now is the time to hear the Lord.
Thank you. Let us pray. Lord, we look before you right now. We have celebrated your presence. You are the God of creation. You are the God of new creation. You are the God who has created us in your image. Father, we pray today for the grace we need to live into that image. For this we pray in the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Just a few moments, we'll be taking our text from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verses 23 and following. If we were made to thrive, what happened? We were created to thrive, not survive. We were created to thrive. Well, what happened? Why does that become such a struggle? I'm not going to pretend that I'm going to answer all of life's great mysteries this morning, but I do have one thing I'd like for us to consider today about that question. Could it be that maybe we aren't listening to the right voices? Could it be that the reason we don't thrive is that we get distracted from the voice, the word, and start looking after all these false words that are going around? Might that be? From Genesis chapter 1, I'm actually going to begin at verse 24. And God said, "Let the land produce living creatures according to their kinds, the livestock, the creatures that move along the ground, and the wild animals, each according to its kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals according to their kinds, the livestock according to their kinds, and all the creatures that move along the ground according to their kinds. And God saw that it was good. Thank you. Little call and response there. Thank you. That's important. Then God said, "Let us make mankind in our image and in our likeness, and so that they may rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the sky and over the livestock and over the wild animals and over all the creatures that move along the ground." So God created humankind, mankind, in his own image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female, he created them. And God blessed them. And God said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground." Then God said, "I give you every seed-bearing plant on the face of the whole earth and every tree that has fruit with seed in it. They will be yours for food. And to all the beasts of the earth and all the birds of the sky and all the creatures that move along the ground, everything that has breath of life in it, I give every green plant for food." And so it was. And God saw all that he had made, and it was
very good.
Thank you. Very good. Did you catch the difference? If you were reading this whole creation narrative at the end of each day, it was good, it was good. But at the end of the sixth day, very good. Hang on to that thought. "Thus the heavens and the earth were completed in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work that he had been doing, and so on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. Then God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it he rested from all the work of creating that he had done." And may God add his blessing to the reading and hearing of his word. Our graduates, whether they were in kindergarten or graduate school, have spent a lot of their time answering questions. Question after questions, exam after exam, all these questions. And they have learned quite a bit, and we're quite proud of their accomplishments. And it is certainly right that we celebrate them. I've been a part of something called higher education for 35 years, and I've learned a couple of things. But one of the things that I've learned is something that I actually think is kind of important. I've learned that sometimes it's more important to ask the right question than it is to have the right answer. My best students actually are those who know how to ask questions, not those who can just spit back what I said. I find that kind of be boring if you want to know the truth. I've already heard what I said. I don't need to hear it 50 more times. But the ones who know how to ask the right questions. Now, several years ago, one of my friends at the university's name is Alan Lamb. In fact, he spoke here one Sunday for me when I wasn't able to be here some time ago. Alan is the guy at our campus that takes the honor students each spring on a trip, normally overseas trip. And on this particular trip, this was several years ago, they were coming back in, and their first stop stateside was in New Jersey. God bless them. But that's where they were going to meet, and that's when they were going to go through customs. Well, a problem happened. One of our students had an emergency health issue that had to be taken care of right then, right there. And one of our staff people stayed with that student until they got the attention. It all got worked out, but the problem is these two people got separated from everybody else, all the other travelers. And they had a connecting flight to make, and when they got to the place where they can go through that line, they were at the very back of a long line, and it became obvious to my friend Alan that these two were never going to make it through in time to make the flight. So what does Alan do? He goes to one of the people in uniform, one of the officers, and says, "These people got separated from us because of a health issue, one of the students. Everything's fine, but do you have the authority to allow them to join us here in line?" And the guy said, "Well, actually, no, I do not." This is the genius question. Do you have the authority to stop me from bringing them up here? The guy thought for a minute. He said, "Well, actually, no, I do not. Thank you very much." He brought the two up, them, joined them in line. Why? Because he had the wisdom to ask the right question. Knowing the question sometimes is much more important than the answer. We have just read the concluding portion of the first of two creation narratives in the Bible. And honestly, I think we fail to misunderstand these, or what I would say, not really grasp the fullness of these narratives, because often we ask the wrong questions about what I've just read. We like to talk about questions about how and when God created. Today I'd like to invite us to ask a different question. What? What does it mean to affirm that we human beings have been created in the image of God? What does that mean? Folks, as a child of God in the image of God, as bearers of God's image, is one way of God saying to us that you are infinitely loved and valued by God. You matter to God. I got news for folks that get off on the self-esteem issue. Folks that think the problem is that we need to have people have more positive self-esteem. I'm not going to debate the psychologist on this, but I actually see it differently. My sense of worth doesn't come from who I think I am. My sense of worth comes from who God says I am. And God says to me, and God says to you, you are my child, created in my image, infinitely loved, infinitely cared for, infinitely valued. Now that's something to think about. Our image of God is about who we are, our capacity to think, our capacity to reflect, our capacity to make decisions. And in fact, from the opening reading, and I like it when I'm able to tie the readings together, we're created a little lower, and the word that's used there in the Hebrew is Elohim, which is a word for God. Just a little lower than God. A lot of the translations get uncomfortable that and we'll use other words that are a little softer, but it's not a soft word. We're created just a little lower than God. We're not God, but lower than God. We've been crowned with glory, God's glory, God's presence. I think that means that we're pretty special to God. And God has actually trusted us to take care of God's creation. I'd love to be able to pull in the second story and pull all these together, but I've just got a few moments today. I'm just going to focus right here on look at all the plants, the animals. They were placed under our care. We human beings have the responsibility to care for the planet. If we went on to the other story, it would talk about us having dominion. And somehow or another, though, our sin is we've got the difference between dominion and domination. Dominion's about governance. Dominion's about caregiving. We're not here to exploit this place that's called God's earth. We're here to take care of it for the next generation. And until God establishes the new creation, we got a responsibility here. In other words, God has given us free will, the capacity to make decisions. And I listen to people talk about their freedom, and I sometimes think we get kind of flippant in the way we talk about God's our freedom and God's governance. And here's what that looks like. So if something good happens, that's on us. I've done pretty good with that. If something bad happens, well, that must be the will of God. Isn't that a little too convenient? If we are responsible, then we're in good and bad. And I'm not saying that every bad thing that happens to us is either God's intent or our intent. Some things happen that we just don't understand, and we move on. We pray for the grace to overcome. But we have that capacity to decide. And one other thing that I have to mention because the text mentions it. And let's don't forget that male, female, we are equally created in God's image. We're equally male and female created he them. In the image of God created he them. Whether you're a man or a woman, you are equally creating God's image. Who God is cannot be tied down to this to gender. It can't. God is beyond that. God is God. And whether you're a woman or a man, you are equally in God's image. In a few moments, Destiny and Jesse are going to stand here at this altar, and we're going to ask God's blessing on their marriage. This week, Tressa and I will celebrate our 43rd anniversary. And I treasure her as one who equally bears the image of God with me. She's my wife. She's my partner. She's a bearer of the image of God. Folks, you want a strong marriage? Recognize that your partner is in God's image and is valued and treasured by God. So my last question today is, who are you going to let tell you who you are? Is it going to be some so-called social media influencers? Is it going to be someone who has to tear you down to make themselves feel better? You are created in God's image. You are created a little lower than the heavenly beings. Chapman and Hall coined these words, and I have to share them today. But the waves are calling out my name, and they laugh at me, reminding me of the times I've tried before and failed. The waves keep on telling me time and again, boy, you'll never win, you'll never win. But the voice of truth tells me a different story. The voice of truth says, do not be afraid. The voice of truth says, this is for my glory. Out of all the voices calling out to me, I will choose to listen to the voice of truth. Who are you going to let tell you who you are? Pray with me. Father in heaven, we thank you for your word that speaks truth, your word that transforms lives. Father, we pray that we would allow your Holy Spirit who inspired these words to call them into our lives now and continue that work of transformation. Father, I pray for that person who's here today that finds every single day a struggle. I pray for that person, dear Lord, that feels so lonely in their struggle. I pray for that person, dear Lord, who doesn't see their way through what they're facing. I pray that through your Spirit, you would let that person know your voice of truth, that you are with them, not against them. For we know that if Christ is for us, who can be against us? Lord, use this invitation to draw us all closer to you, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our invitation today is number 423, I need thee every hour. If there's a need that you need to share through a time of prayer, we want you to know this altar is open to you. If you've never given your life to Christ, you've never said yes to that voice who tells you who you really are, there's no better time than right now. If there are other needs that you just simply need a time to pray, this altar is open. Respond as the Spirit leads as we stand and sing together.
Jesus Christ, our Lord, and God's people said,
amen.